Hi, I'd like to take you on a little video tour, a photographic tour of a Coldwater, Michigan CHP plant, combined heat and power or cogeneration facility, installed by Clarke Energy. And this tour was facilitated and hosted by Clarke Energy, but the station is owned by Coldwater Municipal. It's located adjacent to a large greenhouse, a 60-acre Mastranardi greenhouse. So let's jump right in it. Mastranardi, I'm sorry, the Maro Farms is the business unit, but they had a phase one installed a number of years earlier, and then they came back and doubled the size to 60 acres, where they produced tomatoes, cucumbers, peppers, and some other things. Quite large facility, a traditional glass house, a lot of hot water buffer tanks. When the sun goes down, the internal heating requirement changes drastically. The load changes rapidly. A lot of fancy water management. They take rainwater and recirculate hydroponic water, UV sterilize it, and they have a lot of water management for their nutrient hydroponic operations. They have this neat frosted glass that they claim is a very diffuse, very even lighting source, but they also have some artificial lighting as well. But the frosted glass is one of their claim to fame for their light pattern inside. It is a hydroponic facility, and this growth media with their hydroponic drip system is shown here, and they do a lot with the recirculation of the water and the filtration and water management. A lot of water tanks and pumping and neat things. An aerial view here shows the CHP, or the cogen facility, that was built right adjacent so that the greenhouse can make use of the both CO2 and hot water, the heating. Very large 13 megawatt facility, and electricity is owned and kept on the grid by the Coldwater Municipal. So the facility was built for the electrical output, and they're going to keep that, but they serve the hot water CO2 to the facility here, right next door. Traditional large high bay glass house. And right there is the separation between the two facilities. They do have high pressure sodium lighting. I don't know if it's throughout the entire facility, but they have a lot of acreage that is also fitted with supplemental lighting. Greenhouse is a lot more complicated than an indoor grow room, because the indoor grow room has no natural lighting and has very well insulated walls, so the massive amount of lighting dominates the whole energy equation. So a greenhouse has a lot of air movement and ventilation, no air conditioning, and a lot of sunlight, so it's actually a lot more complicated. Let's jump into the powerhouse here. It's an open pole barn type operation with three of these large J624 engines from Jenbacher. And Clarke is the local regional Midwest distributor and contractor for these guys. It does have a gearbox. This larger machine is not a 60 Hertz inherently. It's got a gearbox to make it 60 Hertz off the 1500 RPM. A lot of the smaller engines are direct shaft with no gearbox. I'm running at 1800 RPM. And this big beast has four cylinders. So here's some specs on it. The total displacement down below, V60 24 cylinder, about 4.4 megawatts. If you see there in the bottom center, the J624 machine is about 42% electrical efficiency. Some of them go even higher than that, but then they recover the hot water. 40-50% of the hot water heat is recovered off the energy, and you have an upper 80% energy efficiency. And actually the condensation of the exhaust to utilize the scrubbing and the CO2 gets you in the 90s. So it's a very efficient operation. There's John from and Chris from Clarke looking at the control system, scrubbing system. Here is a look at the twin turbocharger. It's got intercooler and turbochargers, and here's the gearbox setup right there in the middle, converting the 1500 RPM to 60 Hertz alternator, or the generator, I guess, electrical producer here, you know, form unit. Chris is taking a look. I'm an engineering nerd, so I often take a look at these things up close and personal. 57 kVA, or about 4.6 kilowatt power. So this is grid connected. It's a synchronous type AC synchronous generator. Here's a close-up look of the controls on the scrubber. So this is an option. You don't have to purchase this, but this, after you condense the water out, you can put it through a scrubber, a selective catalyst, to get rid of the NOx. And they order for a whole bunch of chemicals, unburned hydrocarbons, NO, NO2, and I believe ethane because of the tomatoes. So the controller will have a catalytic converter and an SCR that injects urea. So my Volkswagen diesel has a little DF tank in the back, and there's a little scrubbing action that's very, very similar. This is just on a much larger scale, just like a DEF system for the new diesel, clean diesel. But this is a natural gas engine, but it in effect gets the exhaust extremely clean, down to the negligible NOx, and very, very clean, that you can use it for basically food grade CO2 pumped into the greenhouse. This is a little more challenging for the indoor grow rooms because of the hermetically sealed rooms. CO2 is not that expensive, so there are other options for CO2. In this urea tank with some urea dosing equipment here, is receiving the urea from a delivery, and then that would inject it into that scrubber that we just looked at. The controls for that are here, and monitoring and control urea system. But it's just basically the same as the DEF fluid, which is diluted urea that I put in my own Volkswagen in the trunk. A couple shots of the engine layout. Now, these could come in a container, an outdoor rated container, fairly quiet machines. And then I've also seen, like over in Great Northern Grower, tomato grower in Ontario, Kingsville, Leamington, just about an hour east of Detroit. They are in soundproof enclosures inside the building. So they're indoor, but also in soundproof enclosures that you cannot hear one thing on the inside or on the outside of that wall. The engine's running and you cannot hear one thing. So they're very, very quiet when installed that way. So this pole barn type installation with a lot of elbow room, this is a very clean, large, spacious space, is one option. Outdoor enclosures where a lot of radiators and equipment goes on the roof, or even the sound attenuated enclosures indoors. A lot of heat exchangers and some other pumps going on. Another look at the swing system. The radiators located outside can be on the roof. It could be on the roof, could be on the roof of a container. But when the heat load is not utilizing that thermal energy, we have to dump it somewhere. So there will be a thermal dump from the radiator in addition to the takeoff of heat that going to the greenhouse. You can see the separation is quite close to the neighbors here. They do have a liquid CO2 system there in the greenhouse. When the windows are shut, they can supplement with CO2 from either the CHP system or their liquid system. And those are some radiator or heaters that warm the gas up. And the high pressure CO2 gets vented quickly into the system. It gets frost cold and can clog up some valves with frost, so they have to get up a little bit. Other radiators, and this 24 cylinder engine has 24 spark plugs. there is some maintenance, of course, oil filter, spark plug change outs, and after a number of years there'll be a head rebuild that can be all built into maintenance. The service contract and maintenance can handle all of those things, so that's part of your economic pro forma, your economic analysis. We'll bring that into the equation. It's often a penny or a penny and a half per kilowatt hour equivalent value, somewhere in that range. And in the control room, we took a quick look at the control room. A lot of digital controls. Jenbacher or Clarke, looking at this system from remote, far away. It can basically run autonomously with no manpower on site if need be. Maybe not this system, but a smaller package. Here's your computerized operating controls and the switchgear, electrical switchgear, with these SCL relays and utility grade relays, because this is all grid connected. This is a grid connected power facility with all the required interconnections, sensing and relay, circuit breakers, and here connecting to the grid. I don't know the voltage, but here's the grid connection. So I hope this is helpful. A typical indoor grow operation with one and a half, two megawatts would be about a tenth of the size. So don't be frightened by the size of the system. The engineering and design would take into account the thermal load, the electrical load, and the number of engines, N+1, N+2, maybe a diesel backup, but you need to have some redundancy when you're running as an island. But if you have the grid connected, then that is another part of the design decision process. But a much smaller system would have much smaller engines, and it could be an outdoor containerized system that could be a very small footprint. So I hope this is helpful. See what a system looks like. Of course, the 13 megawatt is a quite large sized grid system, but there's lots of shapes and sizes for these CHP facilities. Thank you very much.